the third week of school, and today on The View, there are a lot of new campus events going on. Today, hear from these clubs and find out how you can join in on the fun. And on The View, Veronica Calhoun joins in as our guest co-host. Hear her thoughts on the current campus headlines and more. This is The View on the Hill. Welcome to The View on the Hill. This is your view here in Fayetteville. I'm Martha Swearingen, and to my right is Veronica Calhoun. She's the current UATV Director of Recruiting, and she's today's guest co-host. Veronica, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me, Martha.
All right, so football season's in full swing. We've got college football going on. NFL started yesterday.
Yep.
So yeah, the NFL just recently announced that Bruno Mars will be topping Beyonce as next year's football NFL.
You know, he has some stiff competition as far as previous performers. We have Beyonce, Justin Timberlake, Prince.
He has huge shoes to fill.
What I've noticed is his music is a little more calm. So that's kind of what makes me a little nervous as far as his performance goes. But I think he can really step up to the plate because, I mean, if you YouTube him, he can dance. He can sing.
I mean, he has a lot of chart toppers. He's got Grenade. Mm-hmm. He's got Just the Way You Are. Now, the Super Bowl is going to be February 2nd, 2014. Mm-hmm. And according to the NFL, more than 110 million viewers tuned in last year to hear Beyonce.
It is the most watched live music concert on television all year.
And even for the Blackout Bowl, it had that many viewers. I just can't even imagine what it's going to have next year.
Such, oh my gosh, the blackout. That was terrible last year.
It was. It really was. It's just
they made through it.
You never know what's going to happen.
Exactly.
It's just really that unpredictable.
But to still have that many viewers after that, it's great.
Oh, for sure. And so we have another fun story for you guys. John McCain was seen playing poker during a Senate hearing. Can you believe that?
Oh my gosh. After seeing that picture, I really didn't believe it. And after it, he tweets, and I quote, "Scandal, caught playing iPhone game at 3+ hour Senate hearing. Worst of all, I lost."
Well, Forbes John even McCain posted a story online today saying how he wasn't even apologetic about it. Like you said, the tweet he posted,
shame.
Not apologetic at all. And TinyCo, the company that's behind the VIP Poker, which is the app that he was playing, said that their downloads increased 30%.
So it promoted the app because of this,
absolutely.
Of course.
I mean, this is in the middle of a heated Senate debate. I mean, he's talking, John Kerry is up talking about military action in Syria, and this is what's going on.
Oh, yeah. And apparently his only comment on the whole situation is, if we go for the Syria, we are doomed in the long run. And if we intervene, it'll only turn around in the battlefield.
I guess that's why he was okay playing poker, because he kind of already agrees with the current position that they're going in.
He knows his stance.
So he was like, you know, I agree with Kerry. I'm just going to chill, sit back, and play some poker.
3 hours is long, but I mean, if it's what you choose to do with your life.
It's his job, and he's paid for it. He's paid to play poker. So Tokyo is now going to be hosting the 2020 Olympics for the summer.
Beat out Madrid and Istanbul.
You know, I think that's a great choice. And the last time, they haven't even hosted since 1964. I think that's a really, really good place to have them.
And the government has saved up $4.9 billion? Yes, billion dollars.
Well, and the crazy thing is, they're going to build a $1 billion stadium just for the Olympics, but they don't even have to make it an Olympic expense because it's already being built for the 2017 World Cup.
That's incredible.
So they're going to use it for the opening ceremonies, for athletic events, and it's not even part of their expenses going towards the Olympics. So very crazy there, but until we get to 2020, we have the 2014 Winter Games in Russia, 2016 Games coming up in Brazil. Everybody's heard about Rio, and then the 2018 Winter Olympics will be in South Korea.
It's a lot to look forward to.
Oh, absolutely. The Olympics are always just one of the best times of the year.
I agree.
And so next up, we have this cat that is extremely fat, working out on a treadmill, it's lost about 5 pounds.
31 pounds. This cat, 31, that's twice the average cat. In one cat, look at him go.
And you know, the story behind it is actually, I'm glad to see this cat's losing weight, because the reason he got on this diet and exercise plan is because his owner passed away. Aww. And so, you know, he's like, hey, this cat isn't gonna do what happened to me. Yeah. It's gonna get in shape.
Oh my gosh, and apparently the goal weight is 20 pounds.
He's almost there.
For 11 pounds for a cat?
That's a huge cat, though. That's huge. His name is Buddha. He's 6 years old. And
he looks like Buddha.
He actually does it at a rehab clinic. How
really?
Funny is that?
That's cute, though.
Absolutely. All right, well, everyone, this is going to be a great show. Coming up after the break, Rachel Deans is here from University Programs. She's the vice president. So if you've ever wondered how you can get involved, this is for you. We'll be right back.
Relax, let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly presents
another brand new episode of the Not Solely Show.
You've been to another house 3 times.
It is another brand new episode of the Not Solely Show.
This is horrible!
Ready for another Not So Late Show. It is another episode of the Not So Late Show.
Snorts and
look how we turned out.
We'd like to apologize.
Back to View on the Hill. With me today is Vice President from University Programs, Rachel Deans. Rachel, thanks so much for coming with us today.
Thanks for having me.
We've got a lot in store for you, so let's talk about University Programs. First of all, what is University Programs?
University Programs is a part of the Office of Student Activities. We use allocated money from the student activities fees to pay for all our events, so they're all free for students on campus. And we're divided into 7 committees: comedy, the art gallery committee, innovative arts, cultures and concepts, concerts, coffee house, daytime.
Well, that's a lot. What are some of the biggest events that y'all have coming up so far?
Coming up, we have the Green River Ordinance concert, and that's Thursday, September 19th. Green River Ordinance just debuted their new album, and it's number 1 on the singer-songwriter chart on iTunes right now.
And this is the concert coming here?
Yes, they're coming to Arkansas, the Greek Theater. They've shared stages with the Goo Goo Dolls, Bon Jovi, Zac Brown Band, and many more. So they're great.
Big name.
Yes.
Okay.
Also, we have the Upright Citizens Brigade comedy show coming. And that's featuring Matt Besser, who's an Arkansas native, and Horacio Sands, which was a former SNL cast member. And it will be an improv show, so it'll be one of a kind.
So tell me what some of the biggest events y'all have had in the past are.
Last year, we hosted the Mike Birbiglia comedy show.
I went to that.
Yes, so we had him come. We also host the Spring Carnival, you see, right around finals week with all the carnival food and games. So those are two of our major ones we did last semester.
Okay, now, can you explain more about the Goop Troop art exhibit?
Yes, we just finished that. That was our first art exhibit of the new school year.
Okay.
And we featured a group of local artists that call themselves the Goop Troop from Fayetteville.
Okay.
And it was all types of artwork, and that exhibit just wrapped up about 2 weeks ago.
Now, for all you freshmen out there who haven't really gotten around to Newswire yet, those art exhibits are posted on there, are they not? For every art exhibit is posted. The times are there, the dates are there, so definitely be sure to go check those out.
Exactly.
Okay, well how can they get involved?
If you're wanting to get involved, you can go up.uarc.edu and sign up online to get involved on any of the committees. Or you can also just come up to our office. We're on the top floor of the front bar of the Union, level 6. And we're always around, so just come ask us how you can get involved.
Now, are all of your events, since y'all are based in the Union, are all of your events also in the Union?
No, they're all over campus. Okay. A majority of our events are in the Union. We have movies every Thursday night that are in our video theater in the Union. We also do things in the ballroom and the theater, but we also have things in the Greek Theater, on the Union Mall, in front of the Union, and all across campus.
Well, it sure sounds like that is a lot of great things going on. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll come right back with more on The View.
Relax, let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly presents
another brand new episode of the Not Solely Show.
You've been saying that house 3 times.
It is another brand new episode of the Not Solely Show.
This is horrible!
Ready for another Not So Late Show. It is another episode of the Not So Late Show.
Snorts.
Look how we turned out.
We'd like to apologize.
Guess what day it is?
Hey Chelsea!
Guess what day it is? It's Crossfire.
Woo woo! Crossfire!
back.
This is View on the Hill, your view from right here in Fayetteville. Veronica Calhoun is here to my right, and we have a few new additions to the university's campus. We've highlighted some of them last week, but this week we're going to actually kind of focus on them. So here, let's take a first look at HOTS, the new Honors Hall. It's a new residence hall, but for so many years, it was a residence hall, but it housed so many different organizations, like housing was based mm-hmm. in there. There were some international groups based in there.
They completely renovated this place.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I haven't been inside, but mm-hmm. I know last show we had ASU President Bo Renner was here, yeah. and he said HOTS makes him wish he was an honor student so he could have lived in it.
It's nice.
I mean,
I haven't been looking at this video. It looks like a quality dorm. I lived in Yoakum personally my freshman year. And not hating on Yoakum, it was great. But compared to that,
yeah, and it's just, you know, I honestly kind of could have seen this coming because of how much enrollment has grown.
Exactly. And supposedly renovations are coming to Yoakum and Holcomb. Is it? No, wait. Yeah, Holcomb Hall, right?
Holcomb or Humphreys?
Humphreys, yes. Humphreys Hall.
Well, I mean, I'm not surprised to see it because with the enrollment Absolutely. Growing, it's about time that HOTS got turned back into a residence
exactly.
hall, which was its original intended purpose. Mm-hmm. So, but yeah, like that theater there we just saw a second ago, it looks so much more modern, so refurbished.
Exactly. It's refreshing to look at.
It's
instead
a great
of
renovation.
The old look, which was a little dated.
That right there actually kind of reminds you of the Union Technology Center.
Yeah, yeah,
a little
exactly.
bit. Actually kind of looked like that for a bit. And we also have Founders Hall, which is another new residence mm-hmm. hall. There are so many fast food places in there, you all. I don't know if you've been in it yet. I haven't personally, mm-hmm. but I've heard there's Slim's.
I'm so excited about that part, which is, I think, Asian food?
Chef Jet, yes.
Okay, okay.
Yes, I've never had it, but I'm very excited to try it.
Just look at that building, that architecture. Oh, my goodness.
It's like when you walk out of Kimple, all you can do is look up.
This magnificent building is just in front of you.
It's right in front of you. I mean, you look up, there's like, I don't even know how many tens of feet. You look straight up, it's right there. And
the study rooms are amazing. You don't even have to go to the library if you live in this dorm.
And then to the side, to the left, you see Humphreys and Yoakum there.
Beautiful as well.
And that beautiful Dixon Street view we have from that. I want to go to that room just to see that.
I know. It looks awesome.
It does. And it looks like people can even draw on
it's
the walls.
It's almost like a even updated Maple. This looks even more... I don't know, maybe newer than Maple,
yeah.
the look-wise.
That's true, because Maple was built a couple of years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So
still very nice dorms, but Founders,
right.
I think, tops the list as far as U of A dorms.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. So Veronica, mm-hmm. All right. The university's changed and grown a lot, but, you know, since you got here, but what do you think?
About the changes? Well,
yeah.
Whenever I got here freshman year, there was basically no construction going on at all.
Right.
And about probably my junior year, I'm a senior now, it just
sure.
completely took over the campus. It was almost overwhelming walking to class with all that construction, gates going up. There'd be gates going in between whenever you're
Absolutely
walking to
true.
Old Main, blocking you getting to class. So that part was a little hard to get used to. But I love the fact that we are growing as a school and a university. And the future classes to come are going to love this. They get Slim's Chicken inside a dorm. That is awesome.
Yeah. And you know, we actually even have, an interview with one of the people from Founders Hall, so let's take a look at that.
Really?
Founders Hall is different because its residents are really excited because we're such a new building that they have a chance to build all new traditions and build this community. And whether or not they can articulate that, they're very excited to be a part of that new community. Yeah, the students here are great. I constantly, whenever I'm in the building, I see them studying together, making plans together, getting back from eating late night, playing ping pong. They have a really great community, and they really like to be around each other, and they're really open to talking to new people. Because, you know, the first day we moved in, I see people having conversations in the hallway with someone they've never met before, and that's really special to find in a dorm.
Now, you know, that really just kind of confirms everything we were just talking mm-hmm. about, how it's grown, what they can learn from it, all the benefits that they get out of it.
Exactly. This is just the beginning for U of A as far as expansion.
It really is. And we also actually have an interview coming up next from a student in Founders Hall. She's the vice president of the UREC in Founders Hall.
Me and my colleagues, or just other, my friends on the Senate, we kind of came up with this big deal of we are the founding founders, you know? And it might seem a little bit childish, but it is kind of a big deal because we're starting a new living quarters and we're going to be starting new traditions. And traditions that hopefully that will be lasting for a long time.
So much awesome stuff going on this year. We'll have more on The View when we return.
Relax, let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly presents
another brand new episode of the Not Solely Show.
You've been here another house 3 times.
It is another brand new episode of the Not Solely Show.
This is horrible!
Ready for another Not So Late Show. It is another episode of the Not So Late Show. Look how we turned out.
We'd like to apologize.
Shannon Deere joining us from the University of Recreation. Shannon, thank you for taking the afternoon to come with us.
Thanks so much for having us.
So let's talk about just what is UREC in general first.
Well, University of Recreation offers a lot of opportunities to students, faculty, and staff on campus, and in particular club sports, which is one of our 8 different program areas, offers a lot of opportunities for our students on campus and faculty staff to stay connected in the sporting world.
So tell me some of the clubs. What all you got?
We have 30 different clubs. We have everything from ballroom, bass fishing, bowling, to the typical sports, rugby, lacrosse, hockey, soccer, those types of things. So we have something for everyone here at the UNIBA.
Quite the variety.
Exactly.
So, I mean, do you have kids from all ages start? I mean, do kids from freshman year get started, or how's it work?
We have a lot of students who try out a new sport. Maybe it's even every year that they're here, and a lot of students continue on in their sport as they continue their education here.
Yeah, I mean, it's just a great way to get, for me, I remember I started with intramural volleyball. You know, one of the things kind of take part in there is just a way to get involved in club volleyball. I took part in club volleyball for a while. It's a good way to stay kind of competitive, but still be recreational.
Yeah, we have a lot of clubs that have recreational components and competitive components. So it's really up to the individual student how involved they want to be. And we call ourselves a mini athletics in the sense of we're practicing probably 4 hours a week, traveling across the country. Last year, our clubs traveled over 75,000 miles collectively and traveled to probably 9 or so different national championships and represented the University of Arkansas proudly.
It really just seems like a hole in the wall because you don't really know about it unless you kind of look into it. I feel like that should get a lot more recognition.
Right, right.
Like
that's what we're trying to fix that.
So, you know, how do people find out about UREC? Where are you in social media? Can you find you on the website, on Twitter? Where are y'all?
We are totally into the social media world. University Recreation, not only do we have our website, urec.uark.edu, along with the individual program areas down there, but we're on Facebook. You can search University Recreation as well as Arkansas Club Sport. And then we're also on Twitter and Instagram. And who knows what the next social media thing will be.
And there's the ballroom dancing. I tell you what, I have wanted to do that since I've been here.
You
but
should.
I don't think my boyfriend would do it with me.
Well, and that's there's a lot of extra guys there that would be happy to dance with you, and you have no experience needed.
So, okay, well, I had one more thing. Let's see. What are your most upcoming, what kind of events do you all have often? Yeah. I mean, are we talking, is it always games on the weekends? How does it work?
Most every weekend we have a game. This coming week, starting tonight, we have like baseball tryouts, tennis tryouts start tomorrow night. But this coming weekend we have men's ice hockey, men's soccer, men's rugby, all at home. And anytime at home consists of the Jones Center where the hockey team plays.
Sure.
But anytime we have events at the UREC Sports Complex, free and open to the public.
Free and open to the public. All you freshmen looking to get involved, looking for something to do on the weekends, definitely come check that out.
Mm-hmm. And everything can be found on our website with our schedules.
Okay. All right. Well, Shannon, thank you so much.
Thanks for having us.
All right. Well, coming up on The View, more from our UATV recruiting director, Veronica Calhoun. Stay tuned.
Relax, let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly presents
another brand new episode of the Not Solely Show.
You've been here another house three times.
It is another brand new episode of the Not Solely Show.
This is horrible!
Ready for another Not So Late Show. It is another episode of the Not So Late Show.
Look how we turned out.
We'd like to apologize.
Welcome back to View on the Hill. Okay, Veronica, now I know you and I know each other very well, but for those that don't, let's hear a little bit about who you are, what your title is here at UATV.
Oh, goodness. Well, I'm Veronica Calhoun. My title is the recruitment director, and I recruit people for UATV and other student media forums as well.
So let's tell them what some of the things are that we're doing here at UATV to reach out and recruit those students.
Well, some of you viewers may have showed up to Razor Bash, and we were recruiting. We have an open house going on Wednesday from 5 to 7, this Wednesday, September 11th. And we're going to have free food, always a good thing. And we're just going to give you like a little peek into what UATV really is. We have specialty shows such as this one going on every single day of the week, except for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And we have nightly news at 9.
Yes, we do. And speaking of open house, one thing that we are going to do that's very unique to this year's open house is the whole crowd that shows up is going to be able to take part in the Not So Late Show, one of our other specialty shows that night.
That's one of our comedy shows.
Yes, it's hilarious. It's a lot of fun. And everyone that comes is going to get to be a part of the studio audience. So it's going to be a great show.
I think people should definitely show up to that.
Because
it's a good time. That's the best show to go on. It's just a good time no matter what.
Absolutely. Even if you don't want to get involved in UATV, just come and watch the Not So Late Show because you're going to get a laugh at least somewhere.
And free food.
Can't
turn that down.
That is absolutely true. Tomorrow there's also a freshman gathering where we'll be talking to the Media Society classes. So we'll be there if you guys are interested. Be sure to go check that out. We may even do some special promotions for Bikes, Bus, and Barbecue. So keep your eyes peeled.
Best weekend in Fayetteville.
Absolutely.
Or worst if you hate loud sounds. But best for people who love funnel cakes.
Absolutely. And before we go, I want to say one more thing. Justin Moore is coming this week.
Is that put on by University Athletics?
It is put on. Yes, it is. He's coming to the game for Southern Miss here in Fayetteville on Saturday. And so he's going to do a free public concert. First come, first serve.
Sounds good to me.
Absolutely. Well, it's been a great show today. We're glad you joined us on The View. This show is about you and the U of A. Would you or your club like to